Black power in sports. The Black power movement in sports began with the racial integration, and the integration of sports began largely with Lester Rodney. Lester Rodney was a sports journalist, and during the 1930s, he began and led a campaign to integrate baseball. He was one of the first men to suggest that sports could be a medium not just for athleticism, but also for activism. Rodney scouted and promoted Jackie Robinson for many years before he was finally accepted to the Brooklyn Dodgers in 1947. Throughout much of his career, Jackie Robinson endured racial bigotry and abuse from opposing teams, and in some cases, even from his own teammates. Despite that, it didn't take long for Robinson to rise to the top of the game. In 1949, he was awarded the title of MVP for National League, with the league's top batting average of .342. Robinson's career set a precedent for many black athletes who would come later. Although Jackie Robinson had silently endured the racial abuse he received, in the 1960s, black athletes such as Hank Aaron, Willie Mays, and Larry Doby began to question their treatment in the world of professional sports and demanded better treatment. Their actions provided the civil rights movement with visible role models. One of the greatest black athletes of the day was Cassius Clay, better known as Muhammad Ali. Clay was born in 1942. His father painted billboards, and his mother was a maid. It didn't take long for his boxing career to take off. Under the guidance of Coach Fred Stoner, he won 6 Kentucky Golden Glove titles, 2 National Golden Glove titles, an Amateur Athletic Union National title, and the light heavyweight gold medal in the 1960 Summer Olympics in Rome, all during his amateur career. One of his biggest victories was his victory over Sonny Liston, not so much because it advanced his boxing career, but because it was a major step in legitimizing the Black Power movement. On February 25th, 1964, he defeated Sonny Liston, and shortly thereafter, renounced the name Cassius Clay and adopted the black Muslim name Muhammad Ali. His victory, coupled with his conversion, forced people to take the Black Power movement more seriously. The same is true for Tommy Smith and John Carlos, who performed the Power to the People salute at the 1968 Summer Olympics in Mexico City after winning gold and bronze respectively in the 200-meter dash. The victories of these athletes affiliated with Black Power forced people to take the Black Power movement more seriously and demanded respect. Perhaps the achievements of these black athletes are best summed up in the words of Jackie Robinson.